just, to me, it's great to be here, you know, going our ninth season, always a, looking forward to new kids coming in, stepping in, whether it's on the whole, I mean, offensive line, offensive general, so to me, looking forward to the season getting started today. And the kids have had a great summer. Just me, you know, getting with them the last couple of days, getting back. I think they're very productive, and it's starting to take that ownership and leadership we're looking for. So we're looking forward to starting practice today. Any questions you guys have, feel free.
Hey, John, I understand this as well, but what made Elgin Jenkins the right pick for center?
Yeah, I think Elgin is you know, last year we played guard for us, the end of the season, played tackle for us, beginning of the season, the year before that, played tackle, and even during the bowl practice, there was a lot of center. Knowing that was going to be kind of going into this year with Jamal leaving last year was, okay, who's going to do that position? And then through a lot of the bowl practice, Elton played center and guard through that with Deion being hurt going into the bowl game. So it was, and, you know, it's a natural fit for kids that you see in the program. Hey, the first thing I was in for with the center is can they communicate? Okay, because they're the center of everything. And all the years doing this is that guy's going to set both sides going. So to me, he's got a great knowledge of the game. He's a communicator, likes to talk. So to me, he did a great job in that bowl practice of it. So to me, and he's played a lot of football, so he's got a lot of that knowledge to what's going on, playing different positions already. It's not much of a transition for him going in there. So to me, I'm looking forward to watching him, you know, go at it today. He's done a great job again all summer. And just again, talking to him as he's had the questions of how's it going to be different. In some parts, it's easier because you got two guys next to you that you're playing someone on the phone, but that's the big communication that comes on the center for me. Different than being a tackle, you're kind of battling by yourself. Here he's got people around, so it's just a matter of getting them going the right way is the biggest thing for him. But, you know, having knowledge in the game, I think that's the biggest thing. So Martinez had all spring doing center, which is the same thing. He's accumulated a lot of knowledge since he's been here in the game. So to watch him do it during the spring, so you have two good guys that have very good knowledge in the game that are good leaders for me, that it's fitting for them.
Coach, you've got some returning starters on the left side and center, but the right side of the line looks to be kind of in transition. How do you see those position battles working out?
Yeah, they're going to flip a couple guys over right and left. Just to, you know, I talked to Deion about that, Deion going over to the right side a little bit just to help, in a sense, like Stuart Gregg, where younger guys are. Daryl, I mean, Daryl's played a little bit last year. Daryl's been around. He's had a lot of reps, you know, through the spring. He did a great job. I think he had a great spring. And then for him was, hey, go over there. Martinez has more experience. It kind of helps them. And then helping be in the middle is going to help everybody. You know, I think the biggest thing is the right tackle with it has the least amount of experience. That's why, to me, Deion has the most experience. This way he's over there helping them, you know, just get through with calls and communication and do that stuff through camp here.
Coach, obviously, Martinez had a very good second half of the season last year. When did you kind of see as his coach that light come on, or really he'd start to get comfortable?
I think weekly with him, you know, each week he got better and better because I think he's a terrific kid. He's very conscious about what he does. It's important to him, you know, on the field, off the field, everything he does. He comes from a great family. So to me, you saw it in recruiting with him, and you saw it through his first year in his red shirt, and really to me, I learned a lot with him was after he got here in the spring out of junior college, and after spring of, okay, going into the season, him understanding, you know, a lot of kids come out of junior college, I'm playing, I'm the starter, I'm the right guy. And once you verbalize to them, here's a situation. You can go in there not knowing half the stuff you're doing and play a season or get a year under your belt of practice and all those other things. You're mature, now you have two full years to get, let's say, 2,000 reps compared to 1,000 reps of knowing what you're doing and 500 not knowing what you're doing. And he understood it. You know, to me, even after the first game he played last year, or the game in LSU, he came back and said, I said, imagine if you did this a year ago. He's like, no. I said, so it's something that he understands it and he learned it and he wants the best for him and the best for the program. So I think that was, you see the maturity with him doing that. And it came weekly.
Going off of that with Martinez, he seems like a guy that's coming in with a lot of accolades and preseason, just hype in general. What is the biggest part of this game that you look at to make sure he's going to reach that ceiling or reach that potential?
Play the way he's supposed to play. The preseason stuff, and we had discussion the last 2 weeks about it with him. It's preseason stuff. Preseason, a lot of things. I said they predict us every season. They predict this, that, everything. I said the media has a frenzy with what they want to put as a preseason, or what is it, like a And so it's, I said, you got about 9 months to figure that out and work that out. I said, really, all that stuff means nothing until the next 4 months you figure out to play the way you're supposed to play, do what you're supposed to do, and don't worry about all that stuff. That stuff will come after you perform and do what you're supposed to do. He understands that. You know, so to me, I said, you worry, start worrying about those things, you have nothing in the end. I said, they're going to get you again. The other aspect of it, I said, it's just the process you've been going through since you've been here. Stay in that process, and everything will take care of what needs to take care of in the end.
You, Dan, and Billy have kind of shared the play calling duties over the last couple of years. How have you all kind of made that work in the communication on game days?
I guess we've sat together for 17 years. it's hard to say that, and really, it's been, I think it's 17. We were talking about that the other day. It's been that long. So it's kind of one of those things of it works. I guess if you had to break it down, here's exactly how. Is he going to call this play? Is he going to call this play? Is he going to call that play? It's kind of, I guess we know each other well enough now that here's how it's going to work. So it's game day, it kind of goes. You know, I hate to put an exact science on it. Here's how it's going to work. Or, hey, this week we're going to do this. These we're going to do this. We all have a great understanding of the offense. We all have a great understanding of our kids. So when it comes down to it, here's the situation. Hey, what can your kids do? What can we do here? What do you see? And, you know, it's just a great feel for each other. And, worked together a long time, so it's it works well.
What were your impressions of the young tackle Stuart Reese and Greg Allen this spring, and who else do you think could possibly work at right tackle where Stuart is too?
It is really, I mean, right now to me, you mentioned Stuart, you mentioned Greg. I mean, Tyree came in, had a good spring, learned, see how much he transitioned over the summer. Evans Wilkerson has done a great job since he's been here. You know, and so there's four guys that can do it. You know, it can come to anything, but those four guys really go into camp competing for what they're going to compete for. And Ronald Collins played a lot of tackle, he's played a lot of reps, he's played a lot in the game. But there's really four or five guys that are going to compete for that job, and I told them all. I told Martinez the same thing. There's five, six guys competing for tackle jobs. Make sure you do your job to maintain what you have. You know, I think everything is, I tell them, every committed camp, every job's open. I said, because either during the summer, some kids mature and learn and get going and want to play, and they realize they want to play, so they start pushing themselves and working a little harder to get that. So, you know, we'll see as we go through camp.
Maybe I'm a little slow, but I didn't quite catch it. Where do you want Deion Kelvin to play, left side or right side? And how do you feel about the quality of depth that you guys have?
He'll start on the right side today. We'll go out to today and on the right side. Just again, like we talked about, is we'll have the right tackle position to roll with the least amount of experience. So to me, Deion has the most amount of experience. So to me, the communication, helping those guys with calls and things that we do, just to me, Deion can play both of them. He's played both of them. So it's for him to go in there and, again, help him a little bit as we go through it. But really about, I think, 2 years ago, it was the same thing when I moved guys around because Justin Maloney came in to make sure he was here. Justin Seymour was the whole thing. Justin Seymour left. Justin Seymour was there to help the new guy here. And so it's just to help each other as we get through. And they can all, really all summer, they've all played everything. Gellman's played all three. Martinez has played center in there, so we can interchange them. Who's the best five? And so they go, who's the best five? They're going to go out there. And what's the best scenario for us?
Probably not even a fair question to ask now, but how many players do you expect to play across the offensive line?
Every year I come in the same thing. I got to get eight ready. Eight you can get, to me, in my mind, 8 to 9 you can get ready for a game. You know, to me, and then really, 9, 10, the 10 and 11 are guys that we get that far, we have to get that far. But to me, preparation for a game, preparation for everything is I got to walk out knowing there's 8 guys that can go. And that's really, to me, you should look at is the 3 tackles, the 3 guards, and 2 centers. And then obviously one of those 8 guys has got to be the 3rd center. So to me, that's, you know, that's helped us along the way. And that's for the 8 guys, so they know what we're doing. They're on everything. When you get the game week, the amount of reps you get. And then you get 9. If you get 9, it's great. And then 10 is an even better bonus. But to me, it's really, you want 3 of each to walk out of camp with. If there are 15 ready to play, I'll play all 15. But to me, it's just experience of playing and then trying to, you know, get 9, 10, 11, their feet wet somewhere in the season so they can start playing.
I'm going to jump ahead. I'm going to ask you. Do you think it takes longer for offensive linemen to develop than it does other positions?
Yeah, absolutely.
Why is that?
Just because you know, if you're, I mean, this is an offensive line coach's opinion, so it's a title opinion, is really the physical and mental part. You know, again, I look at it as a skilled guy. If you ask a corner who's fast can jump, or a receiver who's fast can jump and catch, okay, here's some routes, go do it. I can't hide you. I can't say, hey, we're going to put you in for these four or five plays and go execute them and do well at it. You know, you look back at some of the young skill guys we've had over the years is, hey, they will be motion guys, hand them the ball off, let them run, let them use their athletic ability. I can't hide those guys. So to me, in the development of the offensive line is really A, physical. Because physically, kids come in, yes, they're 17, 18 years old. They haven't been in a college weight program. Ooh, they're going to go, they might be 300 pounds. The guy they're playing is 300 pounds that's been in a college weight program for 4 to 5 years. So physically, they're already mismatched. And then mentally, the amount of the speed of the game and the amount of people, the amount of things they have to learn, transition from high school, is so much that it takes them time to digest and understand the game. Once they start understanding the game, that's when you'll see the progress start being made. You know, Martinez, the same thing, because coming in here, physically he was close, mentally he was behind. So the mental part of understanding the game was the biggest thing for him, and that's the development of for him, well, he's developed faster the mental part of it than some kids do. What else? Anything else?
All right.